हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग एंड वी आर डीलिंग विद द पीसीएस और पर्सनल कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम। दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द सिलेबस। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर अनुराधा मिश्रा, आई एम वर्किंग एट एमिटी स्कूल ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एमिटी यूनिवर्सिटी, उत्तर प्रदेश, लखनऊ कैंपस। Let me begin with the first lecture, that is the personal communication system. As you can see that PCS stands for personal communication system. What it does, it enables communication with a person at any time, any place, and in PCS stands for personal communication system. The objective of PCS, it is to enable communication with any person, any time, at any place, and in any form. It is also able to manage the individual call services according to the service by providing unlimited reachable and reachability and accessibility. What is the history of PCS? PCS started at Sprint. The Sprint was the first company to establish the PCS, which is a GSM 1900 network in Baltimore, Washington metropolitan area in USA. PCS promises to provide a wide range of locations and equipments independent of services to a large number of users. According to the US Federal Communication Systems, what PCS is, it is the system in by which every user can exchange information with everyone at any time, at any place, throughout any type of services using the personal telecommunication number, that is known as the PTN. What are the key factors of PCS? These are reachability with respect to location, means be it your home, your office, or in public, or during transition phases, you are always able to communicate with each other using the PCS architecture. Accessibility with respect to device, means you can be connected through cellular phones, wired phones, faxes, etc. Management of service, means it will very much take care of all the services which are being provided by PCS, and the user need not worry about how to manage these services. Now we come to the architecture of PCS. The architecture of PCS, basically it consists of two parts. First one is the radio network and the second one is the wireless telephone networks. What radio network does? The radio network, it helps PCS users to carry mobile stations or MS with the base stations, that is the BS, using the PCS network. MS is also referred to as headset or mobile phone. Means if we talk about the mobile phone, then we can say that it is the part of the radio network of the PCS. The radio coverage of a base station is called a cell. In GSM network, the cell is controlled by BSC, which are connected to MS, that is the mobile systems through base stations, mobile stations through base stations. The BSCs are connected to MSCs by landlines. You might have seen that even to establish mobile communication, you need to establish communication between the base stations using some wired network. Not the wireless ones, but the wired networks. That is communication between the base stations. What wireless transport network does? This is the second part of the architecture of the PCS. An MSC is a telephone exchange configured specially for mobile applications. Like we have the BSNL, we have the MTNL. These are having a telephone exchange. We often go to the telephone exchange if we have a serious issue with our cellular or prepaid or mobile network, then we have to visit the exchange. The MSCs are also connected with mobility database to track the location of MS. and roaming management. The databases are HLR and VLR. HLR contains the authentication information like the IMSI, which is the International Mobile Subscriber Identity, the identification information like name, address of the subscriber, billing information like prepaid or postpaid, operator selection, denial of service to a subscriber, etc. Whenever we try to recharge a mobile phone, be it the normal mobile which we are using, then we have to give several informations like what is our base station, are we a prepaid user or a postpaid user, what is our location, like in Uttar Pradesh there are two parts, Uttar Pradesh East and Uttar Pradesh West. So we have to give all these informations. So that is by IMSI, right? Then we have the VLR. It gives information about the location area of the subscriber while on roaming and power off status of the handset. You might have seen that there are several plans which offer you free roaming. It means that as soon as you switch from one base station to another, they will establish a connection automatically and you will not be charged for it by the company. So this is basically the architecture of the PCS, in which public switch telephone network, this is basically at the exchange, is connected through mobile switching center, which takes all the data from the mobility database. This contains the database of the users, and then it is connected through a base station and using the mobile station. What is mobile station? This is our mobile phone basically. And then we have radio networks between the base station to the mobile switching center, and through from the mobile switching center through the to the public switch telephone network. These are all, and the mobility database and the base station connections are wired or wireline transport network. There is definitely a connection with wires. You might have seen that optical fiber connections are now established to secure the theft of the data, to maintain the mobility of the users as well, and to maintain the security of the database. And moreover, during the OFC or optical fiber connections, the speed of transmission is very fast and secure because we have very less loss of information in using these terminologies or the OFC network cables. So that was all about the PCS architecture and the details of the PCS that we use for mobile communications. I hope you like the video and the presentation, and do wait for more such presentations because we have to know more about the fundamentals of mobile computing. Thank you very, very much all of you for listening it very patiently. You can give your comments for any type of feedback. Thank you.